Happy Lunar New Year! To celebrate, I wanted to make this unidolized China dress Yo outfit from School Idol Festival. I love that it's a maid design, I love that it has little bun covers, I'm so ready to make something simple, and it's just been ages since I made something for myself. This is how I made this cosplay. If you're interested in making your own, you can check out my Patreon where I post all the fabric links, the patterns, and written explanations on how to make all of the outfits for all of the Aqua's characters of this set.
Hey y'all, so today is day one of making the unidolized Chinese yosuru. I'm gonna show you guys what I've got to make this outfit.
You'll need some blue fabric, some black fabric, white fabric, some gold vinyl, black and gold bias tape, some trim as well, 3 black little clips, 2 gold iron-on appliques, and 8 meters of white lace, 1 meter of apron lace, some black rope, and some black horsehair.
Cool, and that's all the materials I have so far. Let's get started.
I started out by unfolding the pattern. Little did I know that there would be so many pieces, oh my god. Once I figured out which ones I needed, I made some alterations and I used the bodice front and back pieces, the yoke, and also collar pieces. I tried to make sure I cut my pieces on the fold where the pattern would match up, but hey, that didn't super work. Be a little bit more careful than me in this step, lol. I also used my own pattern to cut out 2 sleeve pieces. So you'll want to iron everything gently and you'll use some interfacing on the yoke piece and 1 of the collar pieces, so you keep that iron warm. Let's start off the sewing by putting in the darts first in the body's front and back, and if you have an overlocker, use it to go around the body's piece. Use it to go around the body's pieces, the edge of the yoke, and the sleeve pieces as well. Once that's done, you can sew the shoulder seams of the bodies together, making sure that the right sides are facing together, and press your seams flat. Also, press over 1.5 centimeters of the yoke and then pin that to the front of your bodice. It should sort of look like this. Mark out a straight line down the front, measuring around 19 centimeters, and then sew along the outside of this line. Then cut straight down the front of the seam and be careful not to cut the thread. Then you can flip it right side out and flip the yoke to the inside of the bodice. And then, of course, iron the seam edges flat and then sew along the collar and the shoulder section of the yoke. Next up comes the collar. Start by ironing up the 1.5 seam allowance on the collar piece that does not have any interfacing, and then place both pieces right sides together, making sure you keep the seam allowance upwards. Sew along the top edge and leave the bottom side open. Once that's sewn, clip the small little triangles from the seam allowance because that'll help the collar lay nice and flat when it is right side out. And then, of course, make sure to iron it again. Now you can sew the collar onto the top. Place the collar inside the bodice with the seam allowance with the interfacing pinned to the inside of the top. And please note that you might have to snip the body side of the collar to get it to fit. You can do that by just snipping the fabric a little bit. Once that side is firmly attached, you can swing the collar over to the right side out, and you should be able to easily pin it and top stitch it into place. Now you can sew the side seams of the body's closed and try to press the seams flat too after. Next comes the sleeves, my favorite part. Sew a gathering stitch along the top and bottom of both of the sleeves. You can do this by setting your machine tension to low, around a 1, and your stitch length along to like a 5. This makes it really easy to pull the lower bobbin thread out to gather the fabric. Make sure to reset your settings after you do this though, otherwise you will regret it and nothing you sew after this will stick together. The sleeves also have a small black cuff on the edge that goes around your bicep. I cut out 4 pieces like this from my black pattern fabric. I also used interfacing on the back for a little bit more structure and fit, and overlock the edges because this fabric frays so much. Use some gold bias tape along the bottom curved edge of all of those 4 pieces. And yes, I do bias the lazy way sometimes, I know. It works to be okay, but if you want to do it properly, feel free. Follow the bias up with some gold rope trim right on top next to it. Use 2 of your sleeve cuff pieces to adjust the gather of your sleeve, and then pin and sew them in place so that the cuffs meet in the middle to close the sleeve. And I just love how these look, they just look so nice. Then you can can sew the seam on the inside closed with right size together. Once the sleeves are ready to be attached, you can pin and sew them into the armholes of your bodice. Then it's onto all of the front details for the bodice. I started out by pinning a strip of this black bias tape down the center of the front bodice. Make sure to use a ruler to check if it's centered and pin this down pretty well. Sew along the outside edges of that bias and then sew the bias tape around the collar opening as well. This time I am using like the proper sewing bias technique, opening the inside fold and sewing that into the inside of the bodice, and then you want to start that seam off at the center of the top of the collar around the back, leaving it around 9 centimeters of folded bias at the corner as well. To close that, I sewed diagonally into the direction of the seam and cut out the seam allowance of the bias, and you should be able to fold it flat into a diagonal little arrow shape. But honestly, don't worry about this too much or worry about it being super clean, because the trim will be covering it anyway. Like I said, it's time to sew the trim on. So you'll want to start at the very bottom this time of the edge of the shirt and go all the way around the top of the collar and back down to the bottom edge. Awesome, great work so far. I put everything onto the mannequin to check the fit and also pin on the remaining parts, which are the gold applique and the black froggy Chinese closure, not closures. Random interlude here, but on this night at like 3 a.m. I had a really loud glass shattering noise and I couldn't figure out what it was at the time, but I came out the next day to see that all of the contents of my pegboard had been yeeted onto the floor. Don't know why, don't know what, but anyway, back to sewing. As mentioned, you can now iron on your gold applique, which I recommend using a tea towel for so not to burn the applique at all, and hand sew all your closures onto the front. One will be on the neck collar, one near the bust, and one in between. And that's the top all finished. Now it's onto the skirt. I used another pattern that I created last year for Amoi Yohitotsu Ninare Riko, which is a super bouncy pleated circle skirt, but unfortunately I didn't actually order enough fabric for the full piece. I'm trying not to over-order fabric lol, but it actually worked out in my favor because I wanted the front to lay flat for the apron to be placed over it. You could also just order more fabric than I did and make it a full complete pleated circle skirt if you'd like. Once cut out, overlock all your edges immediately because they're frays, and so any panels that you might have cut, like I said, I didn't own enough material and this is only 1 meter fine fabric, so it meant cutting out a few separate pieces. Then sew your white lace ruffle onto the bottom edge with the right side facing upwards and sew this down with a regular seam allowance. Then iron that edge flat. This makes sewing in the horsehair braid a lot easier and neater. You can slip it right in to the folded edge. I was able to make 4 5-centimeter wide box pleats on each side of the skirt. Cut out a waistband that measures to your waist by around 9 centimeters. I also added interfacing for a more solid shape and then also overlock all the edges around that shape. Pin and sew the waistband down like this and then fold up 1.5 centimeter seam allowance of the other side, which you can then fold over and top stitch in place onto the front of your skirt. Lastly, you can sew in the zipper, and I used a 20 centimeter long black dress zipper, and make sure to use a zipper foot for a nice clean finish, and also be careful not to snag your fingers. Onto the gold details. This is the only vigorous task in this entire costume, so be prepared to sit for a couple of hours doing this. I used a gold glitter vinyl and traced and cut out around 20 or 25 shapes for the bottom edge of the skirt. I pinned them into place and then sewed around the edge of the shape to secure it in place. It's easier said than done. I recommend listening to something very interesting during this time so that you don't get bored doing the same thing over and over again. Hey, maybe you can watch this YouTube video a couple of times, who knows? Onto the apron. This is the last major garment piece. So I'm using a pattern that I made ages ago for a maid cosplay and I've been using ever since. I've cut out 2 apron pieces, a waistband, and also 2 bow pieces and a bow center and 1 tail as well. Once cut, add some interfacing to one of your apron pieces, one of the main bow pieces, and the waistband. Place right sides together, pin around the outside of the edges and main bow, the tails, and the apron base. Then sew around the outside edges of all of those pieces and clip small triangles into any curved edges or corners of the seam allowance. Then you can flip things right side out, press it flat with an iron, and then pin the top opening of the base apron and sew a basting stitch to close that. Then you can sew the lace around the edge of the apron. I also used a zipper foot here to get nice and close around all the little pearls that you can see. Fold your main bow in half with the right sides facing together and then overlock the seam to avoid any loose threads or fraying. Also fold the bow middle piece in half and sew, then flip them right side out and use it to pull together the bow and tails. Once you know how tight it needs to be, you can cut off any excess fabric and flip the loop right sides out and feed the bow pieces through the loop until the desired effect is achieved. You can then sew some Velcro pieces onto the waistband, making sure that they will overlap around you. Once the Velcro is sewn, you can fold it in half right sides together and only sew around each corner of the waistband, leaving room in the middle for the apron base to be tucked into. Flip the waistband right side out and clip the corners. Using an iron, fold up 1.5 seam allowance on both sides of the middle of the bottom edge, and then insert your apron base and sandwich it in between both sides. Pin and then top stitch this as neatly as possible in place, and last touches on the apron are to add a snap clip for the bow to be attached to the back. Onto the hair accessories. Yo has some Odungo hair bun covers, and this is the last piece that you'll need to sew. So using a plate or any round object with around the diameter of 20 centimeters, you can trace out two pieces from white satin, overlock the edges of both pieces, and then sew a small white lace trim around the edges of the shapes on the right side of the fabric. Also sew a gathering stitch 3.5 centimeters inwards from the outside edge. This is where we will gather and make that nice round shape come to life. Pull it nice and tight and either use plush stuffing or use offcuts like I did to fill the Odungo bun. Next, I used a loophole lace with a black rope threaded through it. Lastly, you'll tie a little bow from some black ribbon or bias or lace, whatever you have on hand. And I used lace to make it nice and idly. And that's pretty much it. Thank you so much to listening or watching this video on how I made my China Dress Yo cosplay. I hope that it's useful, that you can enjoy it. I hope my voice doesn't sound too boring to listen to. I hope I was clear enough. I am a self-taught seamstress, so I'm always open to feedback. If you guys have any tips or things that you'd like me to know, please let me know in the comments below or send me a DM on Instagram. I'd love to hear from you guys. And yeah, comment if you like this sort of style video as well. I'd love to make more in the future of different cosplays, especially Love Live costumes. So yeah, just let me know. Thank you so much. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.